Hello, hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. Morning, morning, welcome. Hello, hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning, Araceli. Hello, Mariana.
Ya resucité, teacher.
Good morning.
Estoy con las pilas puestas.
Con las pilas puestas y hoy que se trabó esta cosa. Araceli, you are not in your house.
No. Estoy lejísimo.
Still in vacation.
Soy lejísimo. Todavía estoy aquí en Guatemala.
Ah, okay, okay.
Sí. Con razón, claro, está haciendo un frío.
Pues sí. Sí, con razón, cabal.
Está haciendo un frío bárbaro.
In the sweater.
Hola.
In your sweater. The sweater, the sweater. Su suéter.
Suéter.
Sí.
No, camisa larga.
Ajá, long, okay.
Sí.
Okay.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning. Fíjense que mejor ya no me voy a bañar antes de la clase porque hoy que me bañé se trabó esto.
No, qué
no, miren que sí.
No nos dé mal ejemplo, teacher.
No,
mira que nos van a querer bañar.
Ya uno ya se fueron a dormir otra vez, por lo visto.
Sí, miren.
Araceli ya está activo otra vez. ¿Eh?
Yo creo que es porque tengo
sí,
demasiado usuario de
aquí estoy.
Hey. Welcome, welcome back. Espérame, es que mi...
Your glasses is a
no, no se va a librar ahora.
O yo voy a pasar calladito.
Ya vamos a ver si es cierto.
Araceli de la clase.
Dios mío. Va, Araceli no va a ser.
Yo creo que van a terminar más con... Creo que van a terminar más confundidos conmigo.
¡Qué bárbara!
Ok, ok.
Teacher.
Hola.
Teacher, are you here?
Sí, me oye.
Es que se le congela la imagen.
No, es que es horrible, no sé qué le pasa. No es mentira que me levanté a las 6:30 porque tenía tanto que hacer. Y no sé qué pasa, no sé qué pasa.
No. Ah, pues sí, levántese 10 a las 8.
¿A que teacher? Sí, mejor así va.
Pues sí.
Teacher, sí madrugó ahora.
Sí, miren, estoy hasta aquí de tareas, de exámenes, de que no sé qué, que aquí, que allá. Voy a madrugar, dije yo.
Ah, teacher, una pregunta. Yo hice el...
Ajá.
Yo hice el quiz el 5, pero no veo que se haya marcado. Le sale que ya lo hice.
Lo que pasa es de que tengo que calificar una parte.
Ah, okay.
Les estoy diciendo, les mandé otro link para entrar y están usando el mismo link. Entonces no pueden ingresar porque están usando el mismo link aquí en el chat de Zoom. ¿Alguien me ayuda a mandar el link de esta clase, por favor?
Ya se los mandé yo en el grupo de WhatsApp.
Thank you, no, así es que se me está trabando un montón el inter. Beautiful. Ok, so I'm sorry, de verdad que lo siento, no sé qué pasó con esto, de verdad. I'm sorry. Me entró a otro usuario de Zoom, pero no me entró al que me dieron a mí, entonces, I don't know. I really, really apologize with you guys. Sorry. So, yes, in the quiz no les aparece la nota todavía porque hay una sección en la que todas las actividades en las que ustedes tienen que escribir O sea, preguntas abiertas, así como, what do you do on the weekends? Esa parte la tengo que revisar yo. Entonces, por eso es que no les aparece la nota todavía. Tenían dos intentos, ¿ok? Así que ahí podían hacer eso. Ajá.
En el quiz number 4, uh-huh, también va a terminar usted de calificar ahí.
No me acuerdo si les puse preguntas abiertas. ¿Sí? No me acuerdo del examen ahorita, pero si no le aparece la nota todavía, quiere decir que sí tengo que revisar alguna pregunta abierta. Sí. Y si no, yo igual le aviso. Yo solo porque todavía no los he revisado, pero ojalá que ahora los pueda revisar bien. Voy a hacer con guys. Sorry, guys. Okay, let's get started with today's class. Today we are going to start the unit number 5. Unit number 6, actually. Unit 6. I sent you a picture with the activities, not with activities, with the introduction. With the introduction to this unit. So let's see what we have here. Let me share my screen right now. So give me some time, please. Deme chancecito para poder revisar los quizzes. Y primero Dios, se los tengo ahora. Los de la unidad 4 y 5. Los de la unidad 2 y 3, esos quizzes que son los que ustedes van llenando en documento de Word. Los que lo hicieron en Word, ya los tengo. Ya les mandé el 2. El 3 ya lo tengo también, solo de enviárselos. Los que me lo mandaron en PDF, pues tengo que convertirlos a Word para poder revisárselos. Entonces, igual, me he tardado un montón, perdón, me disculpo con ustedes, pero es que tengo varios grupos de 30 alumnos, entonces, I'm sorry, no es su culpa, pero I'm sorry. Eso de verdad que me ha afectado un poquito ahorita. Así que, do you see my screen right now? ¿Sí ven mi pantalla ahorita? Can you see that?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Great. Teacher. We are going to start the unit number 6. And in this unit, what we have is, look at this, nice places. We are going to talk about the neighborhood. We are going to talk about the city in this unit. We also are going to use there is, there are, some, a couple, a lot of vocabulary about the city, vocabulary about the neighborhood. So as you can see in this place, it says, how do you like your neighborhood? People talk about the popular neighborhood called Park View. So can you tell me, guys, what kind of places do you see in this picture? What places do you see in this photo? I see a restaurant. What else do you see? Mm-hmm. What places do you see here?
Cinema.
Ah, okay, a cinema, very good. What else?
A hotel.
Hotel, that's right. Hotel. Oh. Well,
La Belle Boutique.
Ah, La Belle Boutique, very good.
The gym.
The gym, that's right. The works gym.
Gym store.
Here, the gym is in this part. Ah, the supermarket, very good. Somebody says the supermarket.
Post office.
The post office, very good. The post office is here.
The apartments,
yes. There are apartments here. There is a swimming pool. Look, there's a swimming pool. This is a kind of, how do you say parque in English?
Park.
Very good. We have a park. We also have a cafe. We have a cafe over here. Look. Two shopping cafes. Center. The shopping. Where's the shopping?
The shopping.
I don't see the shopping center. Okay. We have boutiques. So we have different places in this city. And it's a neighborhood because it says Parkview, right? Popular neighborhood. We call neighborhood to that small place where you live. For example, I live in Soyapango, and the name of my neighborhood is Los Santos. So that place is the neighborhood, right? The small place where you live. In this case, the name. What's the name of this neighborhood? What's the name? What is it? What is it? Do you see the name of this place? What's the name of this neighborhood? It's here. Look, Parkview. Parkview. That is the
Good
name.
Good morning, of everybody.
Good morning.
Morning.
Morning. Morning. How are you?
Se durmió.
Afligido estaba que no iba a tener clase.
Ay, no, yo también, viera que me siento rara. The thing is, I don't know what happened. No pudo entrar al usuario para intro A, el usuario de intro A, el de nosotros en Zoom. Entonces, me friqué, así se lo digo, me friqué. Y fue cuando les mandé el mensaje que no podía entrar a Zoom. Y... O sea, lo intenté aquí en Google Chrome, lo intenté en el otro de Explorer. No pude entrar con el usuario, entonces he entrado con mi usuario y por eso les mandé otro link, porque el link es de mi usuario personal. Ah, y que por cierto, en 40 minutos lo más probable es que se corte la llamada. Porque 35 minutos, entonces se me va a cortar. De repente aquí me va a decir, faltan minutos, así que yo le digo y se vuelven a conectar con ese mismo link. Please, please, please.
Ah, okay.
Así que lo más probable es que nos conectemos tres veces.
Pero con el team, con los minutos que van contando, ¿no nos va a afectar?
No, 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 yo voy a hacer un solo cuadro al final con los minutos conectados.
Ok, aprovechamos el tiempo, pues.
Aprovechemos. Ok, so... Over here, let's see, there are some information, there is some information here related to this neighborhood. Look, look, Amy Johnson. Let's listen to this information, okay? Listen and read, who likes Parkview and why? That's the question. Listen and read, who likes Parkview and why? Let's see this part. Let's listen to this.
Page 54, Unit 6, Neighborhoods. Lesson A, Nice Places. 1. Getting Started. B. Listen and Read. Who likes Parkview? Why?
How do you like your neighborhood? People talk about the popular neighborhood called Parkview. Amy Johnson, 32, medical researcher.
Well, Parkview is convenient. There's a big supermarket and some nice stores, but there's no mall. We need a mall.
Paul Johnson, 33, stockbroker.
It's nice. There are two nice outdoor cafes and a couple of movie theaters. There's a new swimming pool in the park. We have a beautiful little park. Yeah, it's good.
Stacy King, 19, college student.
Parkview is boring. There's no place to go. I mean, there's no mall, no fast food places, just a lot of expensive restaurants. Oh, and a small park.
Okay, so they are making a description of the city, right? Can you help me, please? Let me see. Nicole, can you read about Amy Johnson's description, please?
Okay.
Amy Johnson.
Amy Johnson, 32. Medical researcher. Well, Parkway is convenient. Where is a big supermarket and some nice stores, but where is this human will not amount.
Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. So let's read about Paul Johnson. Can you read, Mariana, please, about Paul Johnson?
Okay, Paul Johnson, story 3, stockbroker. It's nice. There are two nice outdoor cafes and couple of movie theaters. Uh-huh. There's a new swimming pool in the park. We have a beautiful light park. Yeah, it's good.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Beautiful little park. Irwin, help me with the next one. Stacy.
Right. Stacy Kim, 19, college student. Practice for you. There's no place to go. I need to have a mount, no place to play, just a lot of expensive restaurant. Or on a small park.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome. Okay, so they are describing the city, right? And the question is, how do you like your neighborhood? How do you like your neighborhood? Basically, this question means, do you like your neighborhood? Can you describe your neighborhood? That's the meaning of this question. How do you like your neighborhood? Do you like it? How do you describe it? That's why in these sentences, we have descriptions and we say, oh, Parkview is convenient. It's nice. Parkview is boring. How do you like your neighborhood? The person is asking you about the description of this place. So it says over here, look at the map of Parkview, and we have to check the places that you see. Check the places you see, and what other places do you see? Then look at the activity C. Circle. Circle the correct words to complete the sentences. Use the post above to help you. So let's do something. Let's work in groups right now for a couple of minutes and look at the picture I sent you. Look at the picture of this Parkview place. And also I am going to send you this photo. I'm going to send you this picture. Complete other work, activity A and activity C. A and C, work on these activities in groups. Try to answer this. So let's work with a partner, okay? In groups right now. I have it. No. I don't have that option right. Sorry, I don't have that option here. Here, so we have to do it together here. What places do you see in this picture? Look at this. We have an apartment building, an outdoor cafe, a supermarket, a fast food place, a mall, a swimming pool, and a movie theater. Oh, sorry, and a post office. So what places do you see in the photo? Okay, a supermarket, very good. What else?
A post office.
A post office.
Swimming pool.
Okay, very good.
A swimming pool.
Swimming pool.
A swimming pool, correct.
A supermarket.
That's right, a supermarket. Do you see a movie theater?
The words gene.
No. The Super 6 cinema.
Cinema, yes, that's right. The Super 6 cinema. And also here we have another cinema. How about an apartment building? Do you see that? The cafe.
Outdoor cafe.
Outdoor cafe. Outdoor cafe. Okay, so we can use this name, right? When we talk about, we can say a cafe. Hey, let's go to a cafe in English. You can say that if you wanna go with your friends to have a chat, just to talk for a moment, you can go to a cafe. Okay, so let's see. Exercise C, look at this, you have to circle. Circle the correct words to complete the sentences. Use the posts above to help you. Let's work on this individually. Look at the picture, look at the descriptions, and choose the best word. Can somebody help me and send a screenshot to the group, please? Take a photo and send a screenshot to the group, please. To work on this exercise. Please. Okay. Let's see. complete this exercise, please. Noah, can you help me, please? Can you take a screenshot and send a screenshot to the group? Thank you. And I have the picture. I have the picture of the city here. Okay, so look at the city, look at the description, and choose the correct word. There's or there are. There's or there are. No or some. Restaurant or restaurants in plural.
Sorry, teacher, ¿va a mandar invitación o lo vamos a hacer aquí con usted?
Ahí le mandé, ahí está la foto en el grupo de WhatsApp. Look at the forum. No, no sí. Vamos a trabajar en grupo, es que esta opción no me deja dejarlos trabajar en grupos. La opción del personal. Sí, individually, ahorita trabajen solitos. Okay, let's see. Number one, what is the correct option? It says listen to the correct circle, sorry, circle the correct words to complete the sentences. Use the post to help you. Number one, there's or there are a big supermarket. What do you think?
There are a big supermarket.
There's in singular, very good. There's. There's, because it's only one. There's a big supermarket. Good. Number two. Look at number two. Look, it says two nice outdoor cafes. There's or there are?
There are.
There are.
Very good. There are. There are two nice outdoor cafes. Good, good, good. How about number three? There's no or there's some mall?
There's no.
There's no in negative. Very good. There's no mall. Mm-hmm. If you see the picture, mall, do you see a mall like Plaza Mundo or Metrocentro, a mall or mall? No, right? In this neighborhood, there's no mall. How about number four? A lot of expensive restaurant or restaurants. What is it?
Restaurants.
Very good. Restaurants in plural. Good, good, good. Imagine this restaurant, savory restaurant, Rico's restaurant. Sounds expensive. How about number five? What is it? Look at this. It has a couple of movie theaters. Very good. Theaters in plural. The plural form of theater. So now this is what we have in the book. This is what we have in this part. We are going to study how to use there is and there are. Can I have one volunteer to read this information in the grammar, the grammar box? One person? Can somebody help me, please? Who wants to help me?
Me. Oh,
okay, read it, please. Singular and plural.
Let us bear too.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. There's a park in my neighborhood. And there's an outdoor cafe. There's no mall. Plural, there are a lot of restaurants. There are some outdoor cafes. There are a couple of movie
theaters.
Theaters. There are no clubs. There's
yes, thank you. Thank you, Katia. Thank you, thank you. So we have singular and plural. Look, you can say there's or you can say there are. What's the difference? The difference is obviously the verb to be. There is and there are. But also, if you use the singular form, you can say there is an, or the negative, there's no. Look, you can say that. An or no. Plural. In the plural form, we can use numbers. We can use just the plural noun. We can also use quantifiers. If you see here, it says quantifiers. For example, a lot of, some, a couple of, or no in the negative form, right? There's is the contraction for there is. And we use it when we talk about one thing. Just one thing. Something else that we can add to this grammar is adjectives. When we are talking about the city, we like to give some descriptions or we like to use some adjectives. Oswaldo, can you help me to read adjectives before nouns, please?
Adjectives before nouns. There's a small park. There's a beautiful pool. There's a new restaurant. There are some expensive stores.
That's right. Thank you so much. Can you continue with this part in conversation?
In conversation, people often say there's before plural nouns, but it is not correct to write this.
Thank you. When we are talking, right? When we are having a conversation, it is very common to listen to another person say, there's, and then for example, there's a lot of restaurants, there's some cafes, or there's a lot of movie theaters in El Salvador. So it is very common to listen to the singular form, there's, with plural nouns, but when you are writing in a text, or in an email, in a formal document, then you have to use there are, right? In those cases, no there is. So the difference, again, if you talk about one place, si solo hablo de un lugar, there is. If I talk about many places, then I can use there are, okay? And look at these adjectives. adjectives before nouns. The park is the noun. What is the description of the park? Well, in this case, small. So I can say, oh, there's a small park. For example, in Soyapango. In Soyapango, there's a small park in the city. In front of the city hall, we have a small park over there. There is a small park in the center of Soyapango. Oh, look at this adjective. There's a beautiful pool. I can say there's a pool in my city, but also if I want to give a description of the pool, I can say there's a beautiful, beautiful pool, right? Or restaurants. Hey, there's a new restaurant here in Plaza Venecia. There's a new restaurant. Let's go. We are talking about places in the city. Expensive. There are some expensive stores in Multiplaza, for example. Multiplaza is a nice place. It's a beautiful mall. And there are some expensive stores there. Like Victoria's Secret, very expensive, right? Or Aldo's, it's expensive. So I can use adjectives and nouns to talk about the city. Do you understand this? Is it clear how to use there is, there are, and adjectives before nouns? Yes, 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 no, maybe?
Yes, teacher, it's clear.
Okay, great, great, great. So let's see this. Again, it says, what else can you say about Park View? Here we have five sentences that are incomplete. We have to complete the sentences using this information from A to E. So let's choose, for example, number one, there's a small gym, according to the picture. There's a small gym. So let's do this exercise one more time individually. Let's work individually. Look at this exercise. And look at the picture. Look at the picture of the city. Okay, the city. And this picture. And you have to unit, match. Match the description on the left with the rest of the description on the right. Matched. Please, 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 let's do this exercise.
There is no computer for me.
I think I can send you the picture here in WhatsApp. Okay, I have the photo in WhatsApp. Ah, no, 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 this is not the group. This is the group. I sent the picture to another group, sorry.
There are no stadium.
Okay.
Sí.
Okay, guys. Here I am. Okay, so what do we have over here? Let's see. There's small gym. How about number two? What is it? There's no what? What do you think?
Stadium.
There's no stadium. Very good. There's no stadium. Okay. That's right. No stadium. It's letter C. How about number three? There are no.
Clubs.
There are no clubs. Okay. There are no clubs. Very good. How about number four? There are a couple of
big apartment buildings.
Big apartment buildings. Okay, that's right. And the last one, there are a lot of
expensive restaurants.
Exactly. A lot of expensive restaurants. Okay, so here we have again, there is, there's no, there are no, and descriptions, expensive restaurants, not only restaurants, but expensive restaurants, apartment buildings, this is the noun, apartment buildings, what's the description? Big apartment buildings, or look at the next one, stadium, letter C, stadium, in this case, we don't have a description of the stadium, it's only the noun, the gym, what's the description of the gym? The gym is small. Small gym. So we can use adjectives and nouns. This is how they work. This is how they work. Adjectives and nouns. And also there is another way. You can say the gym is small. The restaurants are expensive. The buildings are big. But in this case, they are showing you that we can use adjectives and nouns together. Right? Okay, guys, I could enter to. Let me stop sharing this.